Hi again. In this video, I will show you how to solve equilibrium equation in solid mechanics using finite element discretization. The equilibrium equation in solid state can be described as a gradient of stress sigma in the domain of omega, as you can see in the image, plus force applied on the boundary or by unit length, or on the domain as a volumetric force. The step to solve this equation is first to obtain the strong form of equilibrium equation using the constitutive law, and then deriving the weak form of equation, and discretizing using finite element. Here we insert Hooke's law into the equilibrium equation as our constitutive law, which sigma would be E Young modulus multiply epsilon strain. Then if we consider only one dimensional problem along x, gradient would change to d dx, and epsilon would be du dx as a derivative of displacement. Then here if we consider elastic modulus E constant can be get out of derivative, and we have second derivative of displacement. Then the strong form of equation would be E second derivative of u with respect to x plus f equals 0 on the domain of omega, and then we consider that our x is limited to a and b, and the value of u displacement would be 0 at these two limits. To obtain the weak form of the equilibrium equation, we multiply W or test function to the equation, and we integral over whole domain omega. By assuming that E is constant over the domain, we can get out E out of the integral, and then we have W or test function second derivative of u over x. Then we use integral by parts to weaken the requirements on a smoothness of the solution u. After applying integral by part, the term W second derivative of u over with respect to x would be W du dx on the boundary minus dW dx du dx integral on the domain. The first term would be 0 as omega or test function on the boundary is 0, which satisfy the boundary, and the next term would be our bilinear term A, which is function of U and W, and we can see here we have only first derivative with respect to X. Then our solution U needs to be only one time differentiable, and we have another term, the linear term LW, which is only function of or test function. And here if we consider our one dimensional domain along x, our domain would be limited from A to B, and by considering a fixed cross section A, or d omega will change to x dx, from A to B, integral from A to B, and or F here would be the force by unit length. Finally, we have our weak form of equation. Now we can discretize the weak form using finite element discretization and basis function. The weak form is consists of a bilinear term A, which is function of our solution and test function, and a linear term L, which is only function of test function W. In order to discretize the weak form, we write our solution U as a linear combination of basis function n. So our U would be sum of ui n i from 1 to n number of nodes. Then we have our bilinear term A as sum ui n i equals 0 to n, nj. Here ui is our unknown, number of unknown, which is n, plus l, or linear term nj, and we have j from 1 to n. Then we have n equation, j is the number of equation that we have. As our bilinear term is linear, we can get out our summation ui, and we have a n i n j, and our linear term n j. So we have n number of unknown and n equation, which we can solve this system of linear equations using matrix inversion. Particularly, we are looking for nodal basis function that not only the solution is a linear combination of our basis function, but also the linear combination coefficient is equal to the value of the function at a particular node. For here, ui is n phi i. Considering our one-dimensional problem with the n degree of freedom, so we have phi from 0 to n plus 1. This nodal basis function also satisfies zero boundary condition, which is required by our boundary conditions. Each basis function is non-zero at two elements, two neighbor elements, and it is zero for rest of the element. For example, the basis function n1 has value for element delta x0 and the delta x1, and is it's zero for other elements. This makes our computation much easier, especially when we want to compute the derivative of these functions, which becomes piecewise constant. Now, if we compute our bilinear term, which was integral of the derivative of our nodal basis function ni and nj, for the elements which are not adjacent, the bilinear term is zero when I minus j is greater than 1. For the adjacent element j minus I equal to 1, the two basis function ni and j share overlap on one element. and the integral would be the shared area between the two basis function delta xi. For one derivative would be from 0 to 1 and another from 1 to 0. So the derivative is same but with different sign. The derivative would be 1 over delta xi, the length of the element. When I is equal j, we are integrating the square of the derivative of basis function. In this case, there is two element that the derivative is not zero, and in each of the element the derivative is constant. So for first integral, the integral value would be delta x I minus 1, the length of the element, multiplied to the square of the derivative, and the derivative is 1 over delta x I minus 1, plus the second integral over the second element with the length of delta x I, multiply to the square of the derivative. Derivative is minus 1 delta x. When we square it, it would be positive. Here also the derivative is 1 over the length of element. Finally, our bilinear term gets only three value: 0 for non-adjacent element when the basis function doesn't share any element, and when the element, the basis functions are adjacent, and when I is equal to j. Our bilinear term is a tridiagonal matrix because we have only value for I equal to j, and I minus j equal to 1. And our linear term L n j is an integral over f n j. If we consider f constant equal to 1, then there would be integral only over on basis function, an integral over this triangle, which is delta x plus delta I minus 1 plus delta I divided to 2. Then we have for the first term delta x0 plus delta x1 over 2, and continue. Finally, we can build up the linear system of equation where we have our bilinear term a unknown ui u2 until un n degree of freedom, and the linear term L, and we can solve this linear system of equations to find the unknown u displacement. Usually this bilinear term in solid mechanics is our stiffness matrix, and the linear term L is our force matrix. In the next video, I will show how we use this computation to calculate the displacement for a bar or truss element in Python. Please let me know if you have any question. Thank you for watching.